Today, as we gather here to mark the closure of the year of St. Joseph and to apprise the significance of the fifth candle, I welcome you all. Today's society greatly needs a father figure to shield us, to give us the warmth and love when we are apprehensive and doubtful about the various issues around us. And here comes the patron, St. Joseph, our father, and the father of Christ our Lord, on whom we can rely and implore his blessings to lead us and forth in our lives. Let's understand why this year is celebrated. Pope Francis has declared that from 8th December 2020 to 8th December 2021, this year will be dedicated to Saint Joseph. The reason why Saint Joseph was chosen is because he is a constant reminder and an epitome of love and dedication, and is a true source of inspiration to all, especially parents. We as teachers are constantly parenting our students, and hence we need to ponder and reflect on the life of Saint Joseph and imbibe in ourselves the qualities of justice, obedience, love, perseverance, and humility. We have also been preparing our hearts with a hope, joy, peace, and love for the last 4 weeks by celebrating the Advent season. The Advent has a twofold character. One, as a season to prepare the remembrance and the commemoration of the birth of Christ, and hearts to await Christ's second coming at the end of time. Advent is thus a period of devout and joyful expectations. The four candles have already been lit. Today, we are going to light a very special candle, that is the fifth candle. This candle is also called as the Christ candle, which represents light and purity. This candle is placed in the middle as it is lit on Christmas Day. This candle is white and represents pure light, victory, regeneration, and godliness. Let us celebrate the light, purity, and godliness of Christ our Lord by venerating our patron saint, Saint Joseph, and the Father of God, the Father of Jesus Christ, followed by the lighting of the five candles, especially the fifth candle. I now call upon our Principal, Reverend Father Rajesh Mansoori, our Parish Priest, Reverend Father Louis Heredia, our dear Headmistress, Mrs. Shanti Devdas, and our support staff, Mr. Ramesh Gaikwad and Mrs. Padma Kota, to come forward and light the Christ candle along with the candles of hope, joy, peace, and love. Father, please come on.
Tears of the night. Thank you, Reverend Father Rajesh, Reverend Father Louis, Ma'am, Mr. Ramesh, and Mrs. Padma. I would request you all to kindly take your seat. We shall now have the prayer for the year of St. Joseph, and I would request Mrs. Pratima Fernandez to lead us to prayer.
Kindly join your hands, close your eyes, and repeat the prayer after me. Hail, Guardian of the Redeemer, Spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to you, God entrusted His only Son. In you, Mary placed her trust. With you, Christ became man. Blessed Joseph, to us too, show yourself a father and guide us in the path of life. Obtain for us grace, mercy, and courage, and defend us from every evil. Amen.
Thank you, Mrs. Pratima. Meet St. Joseph. May I now invite Ms. Sabrina Garg to kindly lead us to prayer.
Today, the Christ candle was lit with praise to a God who brings joy to the world. We gather during this season of Advent, a season of hope, because we are confident that God is merciful. We have this confidence because in every age, God has shown His justice and His mercy. To show mercy is to treat someone like they are one of the family. God, our loving Father, most certainly treats us as His own children. Our Holy Father, Pope Francis, tells us, God always waits for us, even when we have left Him behind. He is never far from us. And if we return to Him, He is ready to embrace us. During Advent, we hear the prophets calling us to return to God and experience His mercy. We hear John the Baptist call us to repent and experience God's mercy. And we anticipate the celebration of God's greatest act of mercy, the sending of His only Son, Jesus, to be with us. In this celebration, as we light the Christ candle, may the flame of this candle remind us that Jesus is the light of the world, and that if you follow Him, we will never walk in the darkness, but will have true light of life. I invite Mrs. Esperance to read the scriptures.
A reading from the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verses 9 to 40. The true light, which gives light to everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through Him. Yet, the world did not know Him. He came to His own, and His own people did not receive Him. But to all who did receive Him, who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will now have the prayers of the faithful.
Prayers of the faithful. Your response after every petition will be, Rejoice, behold, your Savior has come. Please repeat. Rejoice, behold, your Savior has come. We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, Right Reverend Bishop Thomas Dabre, the clergy and all the missionaries, that empower by your Holy Spirit, they may walk in your footsteps and become good shepherds to guide your people and provide comfort and help to the needy and those in distress. Let us pray to the Lord. Your response, Rejoice, behold, your Savior has come.
We pray for all the people who are sick, affected by the pandemic, suffering in poverty, are in prison, feeling helpless and lonely, that the Lord may give them His light and give them the strength to overcome their hardships. Let us pray to the Lord. Your response, Rejoice, behold, your Savior has come.
Let us pray for our teachers. May the birth of Jesus strengthen them with wisdom to guide us in using our gifts and talents to serve Christ and one another. Let us pray to the Lord. Your response, Rejoice, behold, your Savior has come. Kindly repeat, Rejoice, behold, your Savior has come.
Let us pray for all of us that the Holy Spirit may fill our hearts with love and humility, so that we may welcome Jesus in our lives in simplicity and humility. Let us pray to the Lord. Your response, Rejoice, behold, your Savior has come. Please repeat. Your response, Rejoice, behold, your Savior has come. Now, we will have the concluding prayer followed by the hymn.
Dear God, thank you for giving us these 4 weeks to prepare to celebrate the birth of your Son. You are the source of life, of hope, and of all good things. We look forward to the coming of the light of Christ at Christmas. Help us to turn toward that light in our lives. We rejoice at the gift of your Son, who taught us to love in your name. May we be people of peace and justice all the days of our lives. We are also thankful for all the people that help us along this path. We are traveling to welcome Jesus. God bless our family and prepare our home and hearts to welcome your Son, Jesus Christ, into the world. Amen.
Christmas is about His glory. Christmas is about His grace. Christmas is a gift of love our Father gave us. More than just another story about a special time and place. Christmas is a time to lift the song of
teachers. Throughout the year, we have had a lot of activities revolving around the values of St. Joseph, which have helped us learn and grow. I request our headmistress, Mrs. Shanti Devdas, to kindly read out the report in celebration of the year dedicated to St. Joseph. Ma'am, kindly come on the stage.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, a very good morning. On behalf of our principal, Reverend Father Rajesh Bansuri, the entire staff, I greet and warmly welcome our parish priest, Reverend Father Louis Heredia, and all the parish council members. Thank you for your awesome presence this morning. Yes, this lovely morning speaks volumes of Christmas spirit. Well, today we have assembled here to mark the closing of the year of St. Joseph, which actually concluded on December 8, 2021. During this special year, our aim was to increase our love for this great saint and encourage us to implore his intercession and imitate his virtues and his zeal. At St. Joseph Ghorpuri, Pune, we tried to imbibe his qualities and be an institute of excellence in education where the all-round development of the children is catered to at a very early age. I take immense pleasure and pride to present to you a report of our activities and achievements for the past 1 year as a tribute to St. Joseph, our patron saint. This academic year, the school marked the opening ceremony of the year of St. Joseph by venerating and installing the statue of St. Joseph. We focused on training students towards incorporating a sense of responsibility, loyalty, team spirit, and healthy competition to become graceful and dignified personalities like our favorite saint, St. Joseph. I'm sure all of you will agree with me when I say it's not easy to entrust your children to someone else. Imagine God looking down to choose a man to raise his only son. Joseph definitely had God's trust. Similarly, our teachers have the parents' trust when they entrust their children in their hands. Unlike St. Joseph, who played his role very responsibly as a loving father, our teachers too unconditionally loved the students and leave no stone unturned to bring out the best, be it academics or co-curricular activities. And this is very vividly seen in our SSC results of the past year, wherein total number of students who appeared was 135, out of which all 135 passed, with 41 being placed in distinction, 64 in the first class and 34 in the second class. Social media and our websites reveal our endeavors in the co-curricular activities. I'm sure most of you have watched our carol singing competition. Did you watch it?
parish council members? Yes? And I'm sure it must have captivated your hearts because the performance was indeed scintillating and captivating. The most important and valuable resource that St. Joseph had was his sacred family. And the most valuable resource our school has is its staff, students, and parents. The coordination with each other is what enables our school to function smoothly and grow with new perspectives. For students' growth, we have in school competitions, academic activities that go beyond textbooks and classrooms to encourage and foster a healthy and competitive spirit and effective communication skills in students. We conducted poetry recitation, English and Hindi elocution, science demonstration of working models, and all these competitions revolved around topics representing the values of St. Joseph, his integrity, obedience, and faithfulness. Value-based education is given to our students for self-development and personality development. This is done with the aim to inculcate in students values and virtues of St. Joseph, like honesty, gratitude, forgiveness, kindness, etc. In addition to all this, the school conducts assemblies and catechism classes and a wide range or variety of virtues based on themes and topics related to St. Joseph and his life was taken up. Some of the events were fancy dress, where students dressed up in various roles of St. Joseph as carpenter, craftsman, father, husband, and so on and so forth. Joseph had to face many challenges, especially his arduous journey from Palestine to Egypt, protecting Jesus from the death by Herod's soldiers. But he trusted God, and in turn, God trusted him. We too, at St. Joseph, placed our trust and hope in God and moved on even when the entire world was hit by COVID-19. We did not sit back but had a burst of activity like online education with a distinctive rise with e-learning. And when the unlocking was announced, we were the first school to welcome our students back to school. And we were proud to announce that 100% attendance in the high school section was seen. And we're expecting the same response from our primary section when we reopen from the 3rd of January. So COVID pandemic is not yet over. Nevertheless, as we are going through this unprecedented crisis situation since the year 2020, we are confident, like St. Joseph, that we too will conquer all the odds by our strong will, integrity, and prepare the way for the betterment of education fraternity and the society in general. So before I conclude, let me assure you that even though we close the year of St. Joseph, we will never cease to draw closer to this wonderful father. And as we labor through our earthly life, we will always be open to God's plan, just as St. Joseph did. So with this, I conclude the report. Thank you, and God bless each one of you. Thank you, ma'am. Our Josephite family is incomplete without a few who have been the backbone of our family. It's our honor and prerogative to have amongst us our dear parish council members. We would like to extend our love and gratitude to you, dear parish council members, by giving you all a token of appreciation for your contribution. Requesting the parish council members to kindly come upon stage as Father Rajesh and Father Louis and ma'am will do the honors.
Thank you.
Okay, let's give a big round of applause for them. Blossom. Calling upon stage our dear principal, Reverend Father Rajesh Bansode, to propose the vote of thanks.
Respected our parish priest, Father Louis Heredia, our headmistress, Shanti Devdas, all our PPC members of St. Joseph Church, all our teaching and non-teaching staff, and my dear students. I stand here very proudly to say that today, being the last day for this academic year and also the closing ceremony of St. Joseph, the year of St. Joseph that we had. It gives me immense joy, as you have heard the entire report of the year, how we celebrated St. Joseph year, its significance, its values, how we inculcated through different activities. And that's what, however, some of the activities were taken virtually, most of the activities were taken virtually, but there was very positive participation and active participation that what we have seen. Therefore, as I propose a vote of thanks, I would like to thank Almighty God for saving St. Joseph to us.
He is the patron of the Universal Church, the families, fathers, travelers, immigrants, craftsmen, and working people, amongst others. Although we know Joseph as a working carpenter, he has descended from the royal lineage, the line of David. He was a dedicated professional and taught his own son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, likewise. The same dedication and contribution can be seen by our silent workers, our support staff members, who work hard day in and night to take care of this institution, sacrificing their family times. May I now take the privilege to invite Father Rajesh Bansode on stage to felicitate our support staff.
Thank you.
Mr. Shah. Let's hear it for them, children. Without a surprise. So sit back with bated breath to welcome someone special in midst. Can we have some music, please?
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle bells.